In this video you will know the story of a humble blacksmith, who managed to become the owner of an empire. He was a young visionary, who tried his best to give the best of himself in his work and his business. He is committed to manufacturing high-quality products, in order to improve the plow system for conventional agriculture of the time. Managing to consolidate the largest agricultural machinery company on the planet, valued at more than $70 billion. It was the year of 1825, when a young man started his blacksmith shop in Vermont, United States. His name was Jhon Deere. He was a young man of few studies, who worked as a blacksmith in the manufacture of plows for farmers in the area. Would you like to know how he became the founder of the majestic agricultural company Jhon Deere? We invite you to stay until the end of this video, as well as we invite you to subscribe to our channel and enjoy more content.
Grow, investing.
The young Jhon Deere kept working in a rural area, for a blacksmith shop that he manufactured for peasants in the area. By 1836 Jhon was already head of the family, with five children and a household to support. This led him to have financial problems, being forced to consider new projects. Decides to sell his blacksmith shop and leave for the state of Illinois in search of better opportunities. When he arrived, he found a panorama that favored him as a blacksmith. The lands of Illinois were very arid and wore down the farmers' plows very quickly. So he quickly started his new business in that town. "I was quick to identify the needs of your customers and began to work on improving the conventional plow. Manufacturing one of better quality, resistant and with a combination of steel and carbon alloy. Also designed a more comfortable plow and that facilitated the use of the tool. This new tool was widely accepted by farmers, increasing its sales about 10 times more in the following 4 years. In this way it becomes a plow manufacturer. He was in charge of growing his business, creating a small factory managed by him. But in a short time it begins to run out of production capacity due to the great demand it had. It was kept manufacturing plows in this locality for about 10 years. That's when in 1848 he decided to move again, but this time to the county of Des Moines, where he could settle and continue to grow. This new region offered greater advantages of transport and infrastructure. Likewise, customers in this area were more developed and demanded their tools more. In just 1 year of arriving, he consolidated his company and grew to double his capacity. But he runs into an obstacle, because his partners do not share his ideals. Jhon assured that the quality of the tools should continue to be improved, since his customers should always receive the best of the best. Deere repeats that if these conditions are not met, sooner or later their customers would go to buy from other manufacturers. This forces him to buy the shares distributed among his partners. This strategy makes him the total shareholder of the company, and again the decisions were under his power. With 58 years in the year of 1858, Jhon Deere delegates the administration of the company to his son Charles Deere. Charles was only 21 years old when he took the reins of the business, but he was always advised by his father. In this way he maintained control of the company for 49 years. This decision was made to the emerging changes of the time, where John's son was better able to take the company to the next level. By 1878 the company was being a very solid family business, where it began to be formed by a single person, its founder Jhon Deere. Charles held control of 65% of the company's shares by then. By 1873 John was recognized as an important businessman, recognized and loved by many for contributing to the development of the city. For this same year he gets to be mayor in Des Moines. In 1876 the brand registers its logo, the famous servant jumping. From that moment they become a plow manufacturing company, to manufacture corn seeding machines. This catapults them towards a wider market with little supply. Soon they manage to incorporate electrical energy into their facilities, taking a great step towards industrial development. In 1886 its founder Jhon Deere dies at age 82 in Illinois. Jhon Deere considered himself a man of values, providing through his company the necessary tools to contribute to development. The company run by your son is driven towards industrial sectors. Becoming manufacturers of gasoline tractors for the different agricultural tasks. Invests in buying more companies in the same industrial sector in the country, in order to increase their production and distribution. During this period the company goes from selling $4 million to billing $65 million. William was not only an excellent director of the Jhon Deere companies, but he was also appointed president of the United States Chamber of Commerce. In the following years Deere received many income thanks to the First and Second World Wars, since they contributed to the manufacture and repair of military arsenal. By 1947 the company entered another production course, where its main focus was the manufacture of agricultural machines. These incredible machines innovated the world for their ability to harvest cotton and corn. This machinery was able to collect, desolate and shell the raw materials from the plants. These magnificent tools saved farmers money and time, increasing efficiency and profits. In the following decades the company continues to grow, being today the main company of agronomy systems. Is a recognized manufacturer of construction materials, as well as diesel engines specialized in large capacity. Jhon Deere has a presence all over the planet and is positioned as the most solid agricultural equipment company in history. Currently the company has a commercial value of $70 billion. This is the story of a humble entrepreneur who managed to forge an empire based on good performance. becoming an example of improvement for future generations, and being reflected in the directors of the company. Let us remember that wealth is built with time and dedication. We want to thank you for reaching the end of this video, and we invite you to follow our channel where we seek to grow as entrepreneurs. Grow. Investing.